Welcome to Technocracy Live, the program that lets you ask questions of technology experts. I'm your host, Dirk Ducharme. Well, today we're at the beautiful Phoenix Biltmore in Phoenix, Arizona for the 2011 Coordinate Metrology Systems Conference. And what we're going to show you today is two products that are on display here at the show. One of them is a white light scanner. We're going to learn about what white light scanning is, how it differs from some of the other scanning technologies, and we're going to scan a part. After we scan that part, we're going to take the point cloud data from that part and bring it into another product, Geomagic Qualify from Geomagic. And we're going to see what you can do with that point cloud data within Geomagic Qualify. So to start off, I'd like to introduce Thomas Tong. Thomas is the president of 3D3 Solutions. So Thomas, before we get started, tell us a little bit about 3D3 Solutions. You are a new company, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Our company's roughly 3 years old. We're based out of Vancouver, Canada. And our entire focus is on developing white light-based 3D scanning technology. So we build 3D scanners as well as build software-based solutions for processing 3D scan data and for people to also to manufacture their own 3D scanners.
Okay. Before we get started, let me remind viewers, at any time, you can send your questions to techno-live@qualitydigest.com. We may be having some problem getting email on the show floor right now, so we may not be able to get to your questions live. We'll keep trying. But if we don't, rest assured, we're going to forward those questions on to both of our presenters, and you will get a response from them sometime later in the week or next week. So be sure to send those questions in. If we don't get to them on the show, we will get to them. Okay, so white light scanning.
Yeah, absolutely. So the big thing that we start with is most people are familiar with laser line scanning, but not necessarily with white light 3D scanners. So the big difference with white light 3D scanners and laser scanners is with the white light 3D scanner, you can scan the entire field or the entire object at the same time, meaning it acts like a digital camera. Okay. What you can see is what you can scan, versus in a laser scanner, you have a camera and a laser line, and you have to sweep the laser across the object in order to scan your object.
Now both these use two images, right? I mean, a white light scanner uses two cameras to triangulate on,
exactly.
On the data?
Okay. What happens with the white light scanner is we have a white light projector that you can see up here, okay, as well as two cameras. And what happens is with the white light projector, it projects a series of images onto the object up to about 15 different images get projected onto the object. The cameras take the images in, and based off of the deformation of the patterns that have been projected to the object, that's how we recover the 3D data. And the nice thing about that whole process is it's very fast, whereas on the laser, you're slowly sweeping the line across, and that process can be quite slow, especially if you want to hold some accuracy and get some detail. Whereas with the white light scanner, it stands still here. In a matter of seconds, you have all the data. In fact, in about a second or so, you have almost 1.5 million data samples.
Okay. Now, in a little bit here, we're gonna scan this part.
But
before we do that, what about a comparison in terms of accuracy or resolution to laser scanners or laser line scanners, I should say?
Yeah, the unit that we have here is the HDI Advanced. And what the aim of this unit is to enable people to essentially scan objects at a relatively affordable cost. In comparison to accuracy to laser scanners, the way I kind of described it is, ultimately, we're using optical techniques to measure an object.
Okay.
So you're going to get equivalent accuracies, because we're using cameras, we're using light. It doesn't matter whether you're using laser light or white light. You're going to get a high accuracy.
Because a laser line scanner, in the end, is actually measuring via optics anyway, right?
Exactly.
Is that the deal?
Okay. We're using light and optics. In terms of laser, using one type of light, whereas white light using a different type of light. And you have different characteristics, whereas the white light scanners are very high speed. They get you lots of data very fast, but might not be as good as laser for different types of surface properties.
Okay. Now, I see a pattern being projected on the part right now. What is that?
What it is it's called a focus pattern.
Okay.
So for the scanner, for a white light scanner, you have a work volume where you can acquire data from. And if I move the part, you can see that the focus pattern gets out of focus out here and gets out of focus if it gets too close.
Okay.
So this focus pattern just helps the end user know, helps you define what work volume you can scan your object.
So roughly speaking, as long as the pattern that's on there is reasonably sharp, I should be within the working range of the product.
Okay. Exactly. It's very easy to use because you can visually see I'm good to go.
Okay, and what are we going to measure?
This is a mechanical part that we ordered from McMaster. It's a standard mechanical part that you see in a lot of different types of machines. Okay. And what we're going to measure is essentially the full 3D object, because we need all this data if we're going to do a CAD comparison.
Okay, and from what I understand, we also have the CAD model for this as
yes,
well
we
that
do.
We can compare to later. Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to let John later talk a little bit more about that. But we do have the CAD model of this entire part. Okay. And the whole goal of this process is capturing this part in complete 3D so that we have all the data that we need.
Okay. So show us how a scan works.
You know, that after all the talking, this is the funnest part, because we just have to click a button and we get the data. So John, if you will. So the scan is ready to go, and all John has to do is press the scan button. Okay. And what happens is you can see a series of patterns got projected to the part. And in about a second, we have the full 3D scan, and then all the 3D scan data from that particular field of view.
Okay. Now, maybe I'm not sure if Chris got it, but if he has the close-up camera on that, we can look at that. We can look at that pattern again, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, so what we would do next is, I'm going to hide away. I would move the part. And from moving the part,
it's very, very quick,
very fast. I'm glad I got my hand out there just in time. But to get the full 3D, what I would do is slowly either do it by hand or automatically scan the part from multiple different positions. All of that data comes into the FlexScan 3D software.
Okay.
And from there, you can do some basic alignment and do geometric alignment to align the data and merge it together.
So tell me a little bit more about what we can do with this with the white light scanner in terms of larger objects. I mean, obviously right here we've got something small. I mean, can we measure something the size of a car or whatever? I mean, are we limited to smaller desktop objects?
No, essentially it works like any other sort of white light scanner, where if you want to scan something, for example, the size of a car or a larger object, this is a smaller object, but what you do for a larger object would be you would use photogrammetry dots and then scan the larger object in sections and use the photogrammetry dots to stitch and align the data together.
Okay, so you could all end up in the same coordinate reference and frame and so forth, right?
Exactly.
I mean, there are a lot of white light scanners. I mean, the technology for white light isn't unique. There are a lot of white light scanners out there. What separates your product from the others?
The big difference is we actually started off from a slightly different direction when we manufactured our product. We built a system that allowed university researchers, as well as people looking to build OEM 3D scanners, to essentially use our software system on a technology platform to manufacture and build their own 3D scanner. So the big difference between our system, one, is the affordability of the system. Our pricing starts usually about at a fraction of what a traditional white light scanner would cost. And two, it has a lot more flexibility than a normal white light scanner, because as you can see, we have a basic white light projector and cameras and lenses. And you can completely change out the cameras, move the cameras, and change out the type of lenses that you're using.
If you change lenses, also can you change the space in between the lenses?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. If you do that, does that mean you have to recalibrate the unit?
You do have to recalibrate the unit, and we support sizes from field of view of up to about 5 centimeters, up to about a meter and a half. So obviously, it's just like a camera. If you're scanning in a meter and a half, you're going to get a lot less data than if you're scanning close up.
When the projects the pattern onto there, I've noticed before that there's a lot of different size lines. How does that actually work? How does the white light scanner actually collect the data based on the lines that it's seeing?
It just uses the deformation of the projected lines onto the objects to gather the data. And the other nice part that we also have is, if you don't want to use photogrammetry dots or anything, you can also put the part on a rotary stage, and the rotary stage will automatically rotate and move the object and automate the scanning of the process, so that you can really just put the part on the rotary stage, press the button, and get a full 3D data set.
Okay, so if somebody, so this would allow you to, for instance, take maybe a larger part or maybe even a heavy part, fixture it up really well. But actually, there's another question. Does vibration affect this at all? I mean, does this have to be on a... I notice you have this on just a kind of a regular camera tripod.
It does, obviously, but I mean, the scan speed is relatively quick in terms of being under a second. So, you know, just as long as you're not on a moving train, it's not as big of a deal, because the scan speed is so quick that it's not like you have to hold the object still for hours on end.
So in that sense, it's not a whole lot... In terms of that... the ability to work where there's vibration is similar to photogrammetry because the image is so fast.
Yes, right? Absolutely.
So what we're seeing right now is a part that's rotating on a rotary stage, right?
Yes, exactly.
And tell us again what that allows us to do.
Well, the part that you see on the rotary stage is this part that you see in front of us. And what the rotary stage does is automate the scan process of the data, of the part.
Okay.
You put the part on the rotary stage, rotate it, capture everything from that field of view, and what that'll give you is the scan data from 360 degrees.
Okay.
If you need to do more coverage than that, you would then reposition the part slightly and do the same thing. And ultimately, the idea of these devices is to save the people time in terms of inspection and gathering 3D data, and having it on a rotor makes it fully automated.
Now, you mentioned to me earlier that you use this, one of your clients used this to scan the undercarriage of a train.
Yeah. I mean, that's an example of a large object.
How did they do that? I mean, can you explain that a little bit?
Yeah, what they do is they put either markers, like photogrammetry markers or reference objects onto undercarriage of a train, and then they scan the train in sections,
okay,
and using those reference targets or geometric data, they can align the entire train together. And
okay,
they were able to do the whole train with our system without any coding or anything.